Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we'll talk about how customers can accelerate development and delivery of machine learning models across the enterprise by investing in building an MLOps platform using Amazon SageMaker. Let's start by understanding at a high level what MLOps is. MLOps is a discipline that intersects the domain of machine learning, data engineering, and DevOps. Essentially, it is a core set of practices that span people, process, and technology, where the intersection of those practices coming together really drives value in how we build, deploy, and manage machine learning models at scale. I have worked with multiple customers that felt stuck and overwhelmed with the skills required and the proliferation of tools available to stitch together to build this capability within their organization. Now that you have an understanding for MLOps and the challenge to implement one, let's dive deep on the architecture that Amazon SageMaker uses to set one up. Our setup consists of two distinct architectures. The first part encompasses the model build, train, and deploy lifecycle, and the second part is about model propagation to staging for test and validation before promoting to production. Let's look at each architecture closely. The first architecture is essentially the model continuous integration portion. This involves a data scientist doing typical, repeatable tasks needed to build and tune a machine learning model. There are two pipelines created for this phase. The first one is a SageMaker pipeline that orchestrates the workflow of building and tuning a machine learning model. The second pipeline configures the continuous integration portion. So when a data scientist or a data engineer checks in the code, it triggers a build which packages all the dependencies and then orchestrates the execution for the SageMaker pipeline. We use AWS DevOps services such as code commit, code build, code pipeline, and event bridge, all under the hood to make this happen. In the next field of the architecture is the model propagation to staging and production. Here, we need a new pipeline that will push the model and its dependencies upstream. This capability is incorporated by Amazon SageMaker project. Under the hood, we use AWS DevOps services such as code commit, code build, code pipeline, and cloud formation to make this happen. As a data scientist, you can configure the model performance metrics to allow propagation upstream. Many customers will probably want manual intervention before promoting to prod, and this can also be configured in the code pipeline. Let's bring both of these together to see what component glues this together. As you can see, the model registry component, which is the artifact store for a good model experiment, is the component that determines when a model should be propagated. Usually, data scientists will define minimum performance metrics that will warrant registering a model version in registry. Once the model version is in registry, SageMaker deploys the model and its dependencies to the staging environment. Just so you know, this does not have to be in a single AWS account and can span multiple accounts. This architecture is a complete solution. You can use it as a starting point and make changes per your organizational needs. So let's summarize. Building a repeatable and consistent practice for machine learning model software development lifecycle is necessary to scale machine learning in an enterprise and improve developer and scientist experience. Fosters innovation while balancing governance requirements. Customers are also required to provide end-to-end traceability for model development and audit for predictions. It is also recommended customers do continuous monitoring of their models to detect model drift early. In this episode, we explained the challenges with machine learning practices and saw how Amazon SageMaker implements MLOps to address them. Implementing an MLOps practice early on will allow you to scale your machine learning across the enterprise and provide a repeatable and consistent process. Thank you for watching this episode. Check out the links below for more details and see you next time.